Here is another expression. This expression is coming from Kerala, my friend, who is living in the United States, Champaign. She is living in the city Champaign, Springfield. She expresses like this: thank you for hosting and providing guidance. My questions are, how does one best keep mental, spiritual health during the pandemic? Also, how does one help others to successfully maintain their body, mind, spirit during this time? Many blessings. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Atmaji. My dear Kala, you say you are thanking me for hosting and providing guidance. Kala, I am meeting through this live to take part, to share, to take part with you in this challenging situation and trying to find out some goodness out of this challenging situation. In fact, I should thank you all who are all watching this, who are all participating in this live. You are asking, how does one best keep mental and spiritual health during the pandemic? Actually, we have already seen many kinds, at least few kinds of viral, bacterial attacks in the past also. We were not so much shocked, because it was not pandemic, it was epidemic. So when one region was affected, the rest of the world was available to take care, to console, to show their services, to serve the affected regions or country. But today the situation is so alarming. Almost 200 countries are attacked within 3-4 months. This creates really a very critical, but here is a way we can do something on this. The first and the foremost thing that we can do is, through social medias, through televisions and newspapers and all of the medias, the world governments, national governments, and the WHO, they are giving correct directions for emergency, like personal hygiene, social distancing, and limiting our walking out, etc. That's a very emergency. In addition to that, you are asking, how does one best keep mental and spiritual health during the pandemic? Yeah, now we have to look into the mental aspect of this challenging situation. You know, when we listen to this kind of news constantly, and the mental body is affected, not only the mental body, also the other bodies, the deeper bodies are also affected, is bound to get affected. This is where exactly we have to be careful. We should not let the mental body and other deeper bodies to be affected. We have to be more aware. Not only just aware, we must know how to handle these holidays. This is not a holiday, of course. This is very emergency. Lockdown situation. Being remaining inside the homes. We have to use our brain to how to use the 24 hours staying at home, because we are used to move out and doing different kinds of activities. As a result, our mental health was nice. Now we are not able to go outside. So the mind is so stressed. So we need to find out a way how to manage the time, how to manage the 24 hours being inside. There are many different beautiful ways, creative ways to keep the mind calm and quiet. The first and the foremost thing is that please do not watch the TV or the social media about the alarming news more often. That's the most important thing. I know some people, they keep on sitting in front of television, in front of screen, social media screen. They keep on seeing the same announcement again and again. I do not suggest that way. That's not a good habit. Probably you can know in the morning what's happening in the world, you know it. Probably after 4 or 5 hours, or in the afternoon or in the evening, one more time, you can see what's happening in the world in and around to our brothers and sisters. That's okay. But keep on watching the social media about this. Not going to help much in many ways. On the other hand, there is a chance if we keep on are exposing to this news and sceneries constantly, that may affect the mental body. Hence, we can prevent these kind of things. Be just aware, just know about it, that's it. And move to the next creative area to spend our time and energy in a constructive way, in a productive way, in many other ways. You have the intelligence, you will do that. This is one aspect. Another thing is, this is the best time to contemplate on holistic living. Holistic living. This is the best time. This is the worst time also. This is the best time also, simultaneously. It's the worst time because our brothers and sisters are dying and dying and suffering and suffering. And this is the best time because this is a golden time for you. Because there is a complete silence on the whole earth. You can watch it. You can sense it. Even the normal weather, the temperature of the earth has come down, because millions and millions of cars and transports and things like that, they are all stopped already. You know, at least in this generation, in this lifetime, this is first experience for me. You know, I have never seen this all cars across the world, almost 90% of the cars transport stopped. This is good for the earth, because we, the earth lovers, the nature lovers, we have been conducting conferences and conferences to reduce the pollution and the heating and so on. We could not succeed. We did not succeed much. Now, the divine has taken this objective in its hand through this virus, and thereby 144 lockdown all over the world. This is already happening. This is another thing. You have such a beautiful leisure time. This is the time you can use this beautiful silent time to go into your spiritual practice for your personal growth. As a result of the personal spiritual growth, you get some power within you. You have such a tremendous power. You can use this power, tremendous power, to pray for the rest of the people other than you. You can use the power to heal your family members who are afraid of this situation. Not only the family members, you can send your healings to your cities and the nations, etc. Unless you earn certain beautiful, powerful energy through sadhana, how you will use your prayer, how you will make your prayer as a powerful prayer and powerful healing. So, Kerala, I can suggest to you to go deep into and make use of this lockdown period. Go home. The government say, stay home. I also say in my own language, go home. While you stay home, you go home and you stay home. When I say you go home, when you stay home and stay in home, when I say home, I mean your inner. This is the best time. It's not enough to stay home, our physical home. Staying physical home can be used to go home further to your inner home and be there and collect tremendous energy and make use of the energy again for the same humanity. And you are also asking, how does one help others to successfully maintain their body, mind, spirit during this time? Exactly what I said to you. First, you create yourself. First, you create your own energy. Expand your energy. The very expansion of energy, what are you going to do with that? For yourself, you need only very little energy to take care of yourself. The remaining energy, what are you going to do? Use it for your family members, for the nation, for the world, and for the whole of the earth. This is my suggestion, Kala. Many, many blessings for you. I know you are already doing it. I only encourage you to do much deeper in this challenging time. Yeah.
Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.